Hey tribe, it's your girl Trending Topic and I'm back with another video. I do want to just say thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And today I am super excited. Today is the first day of summer and also the longest day of sunlight in the year. So I'm super excited. I'm ready to just kind of enjoy the summer and see kind of what my journey this summer has to bring to me, especially because my birthday is right around the corner and I'm just really excited to start this new chapter, this next phase in my life. However, today I really just wanted to check in with you guys. I kind of wanted to show off my locs because I never posted my loc video that I created on my lociversary, which was June 6th. I don't know, I didn't like the video that much, so I decided not to post it. So today, I was hoping you guys could sit with me as I moisturize my locs. I just washed them in the shower, so now I'm just gonna add some moisture to them because they're feeling a little dry. Y'all know, living in Colorado, we definitely don't have enough moisture in our air. So today, I'm actually going to be using this product, which is Photogenic, and this is not an official product review at all, but I tried using this product on my loose hair and I honestly did not like it. I just didn't like it. I felt like my hair was a little crunchy, so I'm wondering if maybe I should have added oil and if it would have caused my twist out to be like the bomb, like what I was expecting, because you see it does have like these before and after pictures and I was just expecting like this bomb curl pattern, but it did have a good curl pattern. It was just a little crunchy. However, I've been using it on my locs to moisturize my scalp and I love it. Like, I completely love it, and I have tried it recently in my children's hair and I actually do like it in their hair also. So I don't know, mixed reviews on this product, and that's why I haven't done an official review just yet, but right now I'm loving it on my locs. So I'm just, you know, get these edges real quick as I moisturize. So the main reasons I decided to get locs was because I was ready to make a real commitment to myself. I was tired of allowing people to kind of tell me who I was and what I should do with my hair, my body, based off of my skin, the way I talk. I was just tired of being so censored and I really wanted to reclaim myself and commit to myself. And I'm trying to find the right words to say this. You know, being a black woman with locs typically has a stereotype of like a stud or less feminine and less attractive. And honestly, the only black woman I knew with locs growing up did dress like a tomboy all the time. I never seen this woman kind of like dress up in a feminine manner. So I kind of just wanted to remove that stereotype from myself, from my subconscious, and I really wanted to embrace myself in one of my most natural forms. And honestly, that's why I don't wear a lot of makeup and I don't always go get my nails done and stuff like that. And don't get me wrong, like, I love me some makeup, I love a B face, I love my hair to look done, I like my nails and my toes done, but I don't want to feel like I'm only beautiful when I have those additional attributes, you know? So, first day when I locked my hair, oh my gosh, I felt so attractive. And mind you, I had just had my second child, so of course, you know, that postpartum, oh, I'm not sure how I feel about my body vibe was in full effect. And then I started my locs with my natural hair and I really started to, like, I don't know, fall in love with myself and look deeper in the mirror at myself, like past my physical and into the depths of my heart. So for me, having locs definitely is a real commitment to self-love and growth and just expanding. Now, I said when I started my hair with my natural locks, so that was June 6th of 2019. But honestly, I had initially started my locks back in January of 2019, and I started with faux locks. And the plan was to let my faux locks grow out and then just like retwist the roots until I hit my year mark and then take those out and just, you know, rock them. But I could not do it. Like, I was so tired of that hair in March. By the time May came, I was like, ugh, no, please give me something else, please. So June hit. It's my birthday month, and I was over it. I took them out, and I was ready for something different. And then, of course, you know, everybody likes to try to get cute for their birthday. And I wasn't feeling it. I tried to retwist the faux locks, and it did not come out right. And no, honey, it wasn't working for me, okay? Okay, so I started with the faux locks, and I took them out. And what I wanted to do is actually comb out my ends, and I wanted to have loose ends, but I second guessed myself, so I didn't do that initially. But a couple of months down the line, I was like, okay, I'm gonna do it. So I combed out my ends, and I actually put a picture in. I combed out a lot of hair in doing so, and then I didn't even maintain it for that long. I would say I had it from October to January, and then I decided, I don't want loose ends, and I went ahead and started letting them lock. So I'm wondering how long it's gonna actually take these older ends to fully lock up, because I feel like if I hadn't just done so much manipulation to my hair, they would already be locked, you know, and your girl would be in there like swimwear. It's like, I'm playing. But I also, of course, as you guys can see, I've dyed my hair. I did this at the beginning of quarantine in March. It did not come out exactly how I wanted, not as light as I wanted. But with lock hair, you do have to leave the dye on for a extended period of time, so that way it could fully penetrate all the different fibers of hair that have locked together. And I just did not have all day to be dyeing my hair. So it is what it is. I'm not upset. I actually love it. And you can see my new growth. But like 2 days after I dyed my hair, I actually uncombed some locks. Oh, my hair is starting to marry. I do not retwist often, guys, not at all. But I uncombed some locks. This was only about maybe 3 or 4 locks, and I uncombed it and I made it about 8. So I think it was only 3 and I made it 8 because I wanted it to be a little bit fuller. I wanted to wear a little bang like that and just be able to do more with my hair. So that's why I recently just uncombed those. But I'm excited because now I could just kind of track my journey naturally and see how my hair would have locked. And honestly, I thought the loose ends were super cute, don't get me wrong, but one of the additional reasons I did opt for locks is because I wanted a low maintenance hairstyle. Mother of 2, under 2, I don't always have time to give myself the attention for my hair that I would like, so I figured this would work. And then with loose ends, it was like I was giving it even more attention because I had to take special attention to those ends consistently, or else they would start butting up and locking with the rest of the hair since the rest of it was already locked. And it was too much for me. And I do want to tell anybody who wants to start any new journey in life, whether it's a lock journey, a new career, going back to school, a weight loss journey, just trust the process, trust the journey. The path does not always look the way you pictured, but that doesn't mean you're not going the right way. So sit back, relax, trust the journey. Don't be so hard on yourself or others. Try to be a little bit more understanding, a little bit more caring, and watch how once you do reach your goal and you get to where you want to be, you'll be so happy. Because I was doing this and doing that and doing all this extra with my locs. I didn't plan to like, oh, let me take out these faux locs and block it. It literally, one day I was just like, nah, I'm done. And I started taking them out and I two strand twisted it and I started my locs. I did not plan to do that. So it was really like a natural instinct, and I feel like I should have just let it flow naturally instead of trying to control it so much. I honestly think my locs would have been a little bit longer. And overall, I just want to tell you to trust your journey, and hopefully you guys like my lock update. I will go ahead and include some pictures so y'all could just follow the journey, because I know I have not posted a lot of pictures. And I hope you guys like my shirt. This is my God is Dope shirt. Let me tell you, their shipping was amazing. This shirt came in like less than a week during quarantine. And it's cute. I like it. It's good material. I'll definitely order some more shirts. I seen that they had some like Juneteenth updated apparel. So I want to check that out. And you all definitely should also. I guess I'll drop the link for the shirt down below. I'm not going to do a product review. I will drop the link down below in case you want a God is Dope shirt. And I also will drop the link for this product in case you want to try it out yourself. Other than that, I want to thank you so much again for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And holla at your girl. Like, y'all don't communicate with me enough. I want y'all in these comments. Let your girl know what's up. Why are y'all so quiet? Y'all scared? What y'all scared? What y'all scared for? Thank you so much for watching, and I am out. Peace, love, and light. Blessings to you all. And remember, show your gratitude, stay positive, and show love to the next neighbor. Stop being so hard on yourself. Be kind, give love, and give joy.
Peace.